I would like to thank the organization by having accepted my communication, and it's a pleasure for me to be here in Sapporo. My presentation is about surgical techniques of about two surgical techniques of abomasum with extensive title comparison of one step laparoscopic guide abomasopexy versus omentopexy via right flank of laparotomy for treatment of the erectile with left displacement abomasum. Beginning by making some considerations about displacement of the abomasum, we can say that it's defined as a growing accumulation of the gas and the consequent dilation of the abomasum, causing a caudal dorsal dislocation between the rumen and left abdominal wall. It's most frequent alteration of the abomasum and the prime reason for the abdominal surgery in the erectile. The economic losses resulting from this disease include a decrease in the production of milk during this condition and also the post-op and cost of the surgery. The appearance of this condition is not related to age or sex, but it affects predominantly cows starting from their first calving. So from my clinical experience, I can say that 84 of the abomasum displacement occurs on the left, 41 of the AG occurs in second week postpartum, 41 of AT occurs on third lactation. Most of the AT occurs in animals with body condition score 3. About the pathogenesis, we can say that so that the abomasum displacement occurs, it's important that the abomasal orifice is not placed on the highest zone of the abomasum, ending on the side. The gas that comes in or that forms on the abomasum cannot totally escape and accumulates on the bottom. It seems to atony and or dilation of the bottom and body preventing the gas from escaping and are previous conditions. About etiology, we can say that we have several factors such as food influence, overload and metabolic changes, genetic factors, stress, and concomitant disease, abomasum injuries, and mechanical actions. So to treat this pathology, we have several methods. Conservative methods are used to gain some time when surgery is prohibitive. Restitution by denture and abdominal massage, drug therapy and other measures, restitution by the tour of the abdominal and percutaneous rotation of the abomasum, left laparotomy via ventral abomasopexy, Utrex method, paramedian ventral laparotomy with abomasopexy, right laparotomy via omentopexy and overs method, and left laparoscopy, Christensen method. Surgical techniques are the most commonly applied and developed for resolution of displaced abomasum. We have the open techniques and the laparoscopic techniques. Within the laparoscopic techniques, we have the two-step techniques, Janowitz techniques method, 1998. And four one-step techniques, differing among them by assess. Christians and Barizani have assessed by left flank, and Babkin and Newman have assessed of ventral paramedian access. I use that of Christians and Met in my clinical. After finishing the considerations on the abomasum, I will now talk about the subject of the work itself. The objective was to compare two surgical techniques for the resolution of LED in dairy cows, taking into account the time to return to milk production. This work was done with 127 lactating cows with LED in 20 farms during 2 years. So, I'm sorry. 64 cows were operated by laparoscopic technique, and 63 was operated by laparotomy technique via right flank. Cows with fetal membranes and metritis and dystocia were considered in the study. Cows with clinic mastitis were excluded. We collect 5 milliliters of blood from the median coccygeal vein. Each sample was analyzed to determine PPT, total bilirubin, calcium, glucose, beta-hydroxybutyrate, sodium, potassium, and chlorine. Determination of glucose and beta-hydroxybutyrate was immediately made after harvest by the strip method. PPT determination was made through the refractometer. The other parameters were analyzed on a certified laboratory. These analyses were made to reassure that the two groups did not differ in relation to these values, and that way to guarantee that it would not influence the milk production after the surgery. The cows were randomly selected for each group. The surgeries were always made by the same vet, myself. The milk production was registered at different moments before the surgery, on the day of surgery, and 8, 15, and 30 days after surgery. Statistical analysis data are summarized, the mean, more or less, SD and the value P, more than 0.05 was not significant. Variables not normally distributed logarithmically were transformed before statistical analysis. Differences by treatment group of milk production over time was evaluated with a repeat measure analysis of variance, ANOVA. Each cow had a favorable evolution. The cows in both surgical group do not differ regarding the lactation number, lactation days, body condition score, rectal temperature, heart and respiratory rate before surgery. We can see after in table one. Relatively to biochemistry parameters, there is no difference either between the two groups, table one, two. The average milk production during this period was not significantly different between the groups, P equal 0.42. Altus, there is a significant change in the milk production post-hope, picture one. Here in table one, you can see the in the both surgical groups, and p-value always more greater than 0.05, so no difference in between the groups. In the continuation of table one, you can see biochemistry variables in both surgical groups. There are no differences between the groups. So here in table two, we have the results of milk production over time in both surgical groups with a p-value equal 0.42. In this slide, you can see the graphical representation of the milk production of two groups at different times. You can see they are almost equal. As conclusion, it's possible to conclude that there are no significant differences regarding milk production between both techniques, laparoscopic versus laparotomy. The laparoscopy is done with the animal standing, and it's simple, less invasive and fast, 20 minutes more or less. It's possible to choose not to administrate antibiotic, which agrees with a good veterinary practice. The farmers benefit from this measure, since he can use the milk for commercialization. For the both, the one-step laparoscopic guide of Mazabaxi by Christensen method consists in a safe option for the surgical treatment of LDA, in particular in areas of milk production like my area. The high price of the materials is a negative factor that can be overpassed by the advantage that there are present here, and also because farmers fancy heat. Thank you for your attention.